Hello friends, let us discuss about a very important derivation in wireless and mobile communication, and that is the distance between the center of two cells. Okay, so basically you know what is a cell. A cell is basically the basic building block of wireless communication. We divide a big region into small hexagonal regions and we allot a particular frequency in those regions, okay? And together some cells, it forms a cluster, and in cluster we use only a particular frequency for one time. We never repeat that already used frequency again in cluster, right? So see, this is one kind of cluster where basically we are using 7 hexagonal cells, F1, F2, F3, F4, F5, F6, F7 of 7 different frequencies, clear? So this, for this case, cluster size is 7. This cluster is basically will repeat throughout a bigger region and will cover a large region to communicate via wireless media, okay? So anyway, I am not going to those basics. In this video, I am going to discuss what is the distance between two centers, okay, of cells, okay, or what is the distance between center of two cells, okay? So see, basically you know each region is divided into a regular hexagon. So what is the total internal angle, or we can say interior angle, of a regular hexagon? You know this basic formula from your childhood mathematics concept of geometry, that the total internal angle or total interior angle is given by n minus 2 into 180 degree, where n is given by the total number of sides of the polygon. Here this is hexagon, so n equal to 6, right? So total interior angle is given by 6 minus 2 into 180 degree, that is given by 4 into 180 degree, that is 720 degree, clear? Now what is the value of each interior angle? We have calculated the total one, but what is the value of each internal angle, that is this one, or consider this one, that is between two sides, what is the internal angle? Let us calculate. So see, as each region is divided into a regular hexagon, so basically each sides of the hexagon are of equal length, okay? So that it is called regular hexagon, right? So as each side has equal length, and obviously we can say from the symmetry of geometry that each internal angle or each interior angle will be 720 degree by 6, that is total interior angle divided by total number of sides, that is 720 degree divided by 6, that will result into 120 degree, okay? That means the angle, the internal angle or the interior angle between two side is given by 120 degree for a regular hexagon, and same thing is applicable for cells in wireless communication also, right? Now we got this one. So basically this comes the picture. Each angle is given by 120 degree and each angles are equal because this is regular hexagon. You can understand from this figure, right? Now let us calculate the central angle. If we join all the corners of a regular hexagon, then we get this kind of structure. Now in center we can make a circle, and the total angle in a complete circle is 360 degree. Now see, as this is regular hexagon, so we can say this center to the corner joining lines, basically dividing the angle into equal parts, okay? So each internal angle of this case, which is making by two corners and one center, is given by 360 degree by 6, that will be result into 60 degree, okay? So basically each internal angle between two one corner, then center, and then again one corner is given by 60 degree, right? So 60 degree, 60 degree, 60 degree, 60 degree, 60 degree, and 60 degree. This total 660 degree makes 360 degree. That is the total angle of the center. Okay, that is also clear from basic concept of geometry. Now see what is happening. Here, the same figure, we just joined each corners with the center of the hexagon. Now see, angle BOC, just consider this triangle. Angle BOC is basically 60 degree. Just now we derived that each, if you consider one corner and the center and another corner, it will make 60 degree in the center, right? So this BOC angle, that is basically this angle, okay, this is basically 60 degree. So this thing is clear, right? Now angle ABC, that is angle between interior angle or the internal angle between two sides of a regular hexagon is 120 degree. So we can say angle ABC, that is this total angle is 120 degree. And same rule applied for angle BCD, because this is also an interior angle for a regular hexagon, which is again of 120 degree. Clear? So this line is also clear, I think, up to this. So now, as this is a symmetric figure, if you join the corners with the center, as this is a regular hexagon, so it will make a symmetric figure. So we can say that this joining center to corner joining line will divide the interior angle into two equal parts. So we can say angle OBC, that is this angle, okay, angle OBC is basically 120 degree divided by 2, and that is 60 degree. Okay, so this is obviously clear. So basically what I mean to say, angle OBC is equal to angle ABC by 2. Clear? Similarly, angle OCB, that is this angle, angle OCB is equal to angle BCD, that is this interior angle divided by 2, that is 120 degree divided by 2, and it is again 60 degree. Okay, so see, the triangle, for the triangle OBC, this angle, that is angle OBC, is 60 degree, angle OCB is also 60 degree, and thus now we got that angle BOC is also 60 degree. See here, so basically we can say that for the triangle OBC, all the angles are of 60 degree. Okay, that means it satisfies the condition of equilateral triangle. So we can say a regular hexagon, that means for a hexagon, if all the sides are of equal length, then that is made up of equilateral triangles. And the number of equilateral triangles are, see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So basically we can conclude that a regular hexagon is made up of 6 equilateral triangles. And this is very important result of our derivation. From this, we can derive some important concepts. Let us check. See, our aim in this video only, starting of this video, I have already told, our aim is to calculate the distance between the two centers of two consecutive cells. Okay, so see, basically if you consider this structure, that is, these are two cells which are situated side by side. So basically we have to calculate the length AD. A is the center of this cell and D is the center of this cell. Clear? So see, angle ABC is basically equilateral triangle. Similarly, angle DCB is also an equilateral triangle, right? So see, this, if you draw a perpendicular on this BC, then you will get AO. And what is AO? AO, the perpendicular length, is basically root over of 3 by 2 R, if R is the length of this side. Okay, that is the side which is joining the center and the corner of a cell or hexagon. Okay, similarly, if you draw a perpendicular in this cell, in this equilateral triangle, you will get angle DO is equal to root over of 3 by 2 R. Here R is the same length of the side. Okay, basically we are considering the all the cells are of equal length, the sides are of equal length. So obviously, if for this cell this side is R, for this cell also it is going to be R. So it is clear that AO is equal to DO is equal to root over of 3 by 2 R. So our aim is to calculate AD, right? So perpendicular, just we have to this add these two perpendicular, that is AD equal to AO plus OD, we can say, right? So AD equal to AO plus OD, that is root over of 3 by 2 R plus root over of 3 by 2 R, that will result into root over of 3 R. Okay, so this is very important result, that is the distance between two centers of two cells which are situated adjacent to each other, the length is root over of 3 R. Okay, so I hope this concept is clear. The derivation is very easy. You just need to know, you need to apply some basic concept of geometry. Clear? Now, one more thing you need to know, that is the area of each cell. Okay, in wireless communication, what is the area of each cell, or basically we can say more precisely, area of hexagon if each side are of length R. Okay, so see, very easy. A regular hexagon consists of 6 equilateral triangles, and if the side of one equilateral triangle is R, then we can say the area of the equilateral triangle is root over of 3 by 4 R square. Okay, and as there are 6 equilateral triangles, so area of hexagon will be the area of one equilateral triangle into 6, that is root over of 3 by 4 R square into 6. If you simplify, 4, if you divide by 2, it will become 2, and this 6 will become 3. So we can get the area of hexagon as, so we are getting area of hexagon as root over of 3 into 3 by 2 into R square. This concept also you can easily define from your basic concept of geometry. So this is all for this video. Remember these two formulas. Basically, no need to remember. You can easily understand and write down from the basic concept of geometry also how I derived. So if you use these two formulas, we can solve n number of numericals based on this. Sometimes in wireless communication, based on these concepts also, numerical comes. In some other video, I will show you numericals based on this concept. For this time being, this is all for this video. If this video is helpful to you, please like, share and comment, and subscribe my channel for more upcoming videos, and don't forget to press the bell icon. Thank you for watching.